Hello everyone, it's Vicky and I'm here today to do an update with you on the One Book July 2014 challenge. It's been quite a week and if you're unfamiliar with what the One Book July 2014 challenge is, I will leave a link down below with my video and the other ladies who are involved in the challenge as well down below, so you can check that out if you'd like to see. But in this video, I will be sharing with you how my week went. I did write down a few things just to kind of, you know, capture some real moments with you. And so I'll share that with you as well. My book of choice is the A6 Hobonichi, and this is a little donkey cover that I got for it. And just so you know, I've gotten a couple of questions. The A6, the cover comes with the plastic cover. I know for the cousin, you have to order the cover separately. With the A6 size, which is the smaller, it's like the 4x6, the size of like a photograph, comes with a plastic cover. And my pen of choice is the Sharpie fine pen, is the pen of choice. So my thoughts and feelings, to be honest with you, after the first week have been pretty good. It's been fairly liberating to only have one notebook to carry around. I did have some huge events occur the first week of July, being that it's 4th of July here in the United States. It's a big holiday and lots of family time. My sister also got married on July 5th. So very busy. She's my only sister, my younger sister. My husband and myself were involved in the wedding, as well as my daughter, who's 18 months and was the flower girl. So it was a very, very, very long day. Beautiful day, perfect day weather-wise, and my sister was beautiful, stunning. It was just a very hard day to have with a toddler, or almost toddler. It was just a really long day for her, and with pictures and everything. So I think that influenced a lot of my week and how having just the one book, how I felt with it. And so initially when I first started the week, it's totally fine. I basically just kind of bullet journal in the book. So you can see here, I've just kind of been bullet journaling. I keep tabs on here of my water, my fitness. That works out just fine. And because I'm late to the game of using the Hobonichi, I got it, you know, 6 months in, I have a lot of space of empty, or I should say not space, but just a lot of blank pages to use in the beginning. And so that's what I've kind of been doing as far as that goes. And then the month view, I think I've shared with you, I highlight just kind of the big events of the month. So I just kind of put a bullet point and just use that as kind of an index, as a reference for whenever I archive this. I kind of have a reference of, oh, okay, on July 5th, my sister got married, or, you know, on the 6th, we had a barbecue at her in-laws. So that just kind of serves that purpose there. And then there's also a area here that's really nice. It has like the two columns that you use kind of as planning as well. And so these two columns, I kind of use this as planning also, just kind of a month's look at quickly at events and things that I have going on. It's been quite busy for me as far as like bridal showers with my sister's wedding and everything, because we had the rehearsal dinner, she had a bridal shower. There was a lot going on. I'm hoping that things kind of slow down now as the rest of the summer goes. So I had a lot of things to kind of to keep track of and have written down, and gifts to get for people, graduation parties and things like that. So this kind of view has really been helpful for that. So it's worked great for that. I also had shared with all of you kind of my, I want to do some daily sketching, and Danny Gregory is a huge kind of inspiration for me to do my daily sketching, and his book Everyday Matters, and there's a Facebook group, and there's tons of that. So because I had all those extra sheets, I think I shared this before, I did like a sketch of Stephen King's house, and I have continued to do those daily sketches. Let me just flip through there, because it's, I only have the two little bookmarks, which is okay. It keeps me fairly organized, because as you use pages and with the Tomo River paper and the Hobonichi, you can kind of tell like where you left off, which is really nice, you know, as far as like needing the bookmarks. If you've written on a page and laid it flat, you can kind of tell where you left off. So the daily sketching has been working. And I'll actually come back to that and show you that. And then the bullet journaling is just kind of for planning. And then I also added this, and I had shared this with my bullet journal before, where I kind of borrowed the idea of the DIY fish inserts. And so I just kind of actually turned in one of the pages. This is like a March spread. So this is for the week of, or the days of March 7th and 8th. And all I did was just took a ruler, because it is graph paper, and just created basically the same thing that I have in my bullet journal, just made it to a smaller scale so that I can see productivity with my YouTube videos, blog posts, my fitness, shopping, diapers, because I do cloth diapers with my daughter. I like to just keep tabs of how often I'm washing them, laundry, and then how often we're going to the grocery store. They're all things I like to just keep tabs of. And so I write it down here in the month's view. So I have like the entire month of July here. And then this is kind of from the DIY fish inserts. So these little boxes kind of keep me on task as far as productivity goes for my YouTube channel and blog posts. Same things with fitness. I like to know that I'm kind of getting at least every other day or every other day, you know, every third day of fitness. I would love to do every day, but my knees and my hip just can't handle that. I know that's sad to say, but they can't handle that much impact of that at high intensity. So this just really, I've kind of scaled it down. If you've seen my bullet journal video, I've scaled that down and added that in here. And it's easy to find without having a bookmark, because like I said, when I like turn the page, it almost like stays there, you know, like it's almost, it's almost like fairly easy to find. So I do enjoy that a lot with this book. And so using the Hogonichi on the daily has really given me a good idea of whether or not I really like this book, or and if I really like using it on the daily. So I mentioned earlier that I am doing kind of daily journaling, because I used my Leuchtturm for daily art journaling, meaning I put my pictures in there and I kind of journal about them and things like that. And like my daily sketches were in a different, in a smaller Miguel Ruiz book. So I've kind of taken all of that and jammed it into here, and it's been working all right. So you can see I've put in my like Instax. I have the Fujifilm Instax Polaroids. I put those in here and I'll kind of share that with you. So mainly they're of my daughter. I was sketching this basket while I was on the phone with my sister the day before her wedding. I was talking to her, or her rehearsal dinner, sorry, and I was talking to her. She was kind of nervous about the wedding, not about getting married, but just that, you know, things work out for the day. And I was staring at this basket while I was on the phone with her, and so I decided to sketch it and then journal what I was discussing with her on the phone. This is Hank just kind of laying on the ground sleeping. They're always so great to sketch when they're sleeping. And I am a huge fan of Jacques Pepin. If you watch, you know, like public broadcasting television, or you watch any of the cooking stations and stuff, you'll know who Jacques Pepin is. I just think he's just such a great cook, and it's just such a pleasure to watch him. And we have his cookbook, and a lot of times my husband will pick recipes up from it. So we have it like propped up in our kitchen. So I just drew a quick sketch of that, and then another picture of my daughter. And then also another picture of my daughter. And then you'll notice color. This is why I wanted to come back to this, because I think I'm gonna, you know, take each week how it comes, but this past week was just so much. It was so much going on. It was so stressful. And on top of that, my daughter is, I don't know if she's in her like early phases of terrible twos or what, but it was just a lot to handle. I felt very, very stressed, and I felt like I needed to release, and I had to break down and bring out the colors. So I had just sketched a piece of toast for my breakfast, and I needed to have some sort of outlet and some sort of release. So I just pulled out my tiny little Winsor & Newton watercolor palette. I just had to. I honestly felt I really needed that release, and the second that I did this, I felt so much better. I felt so much relief when I did that, and then I just had to do a few more. So I ended up doing like 3 sketches that day because it was just so, so stressful. So this is my daughter playing in like this little inflatable boat, swimming pool that I have for her. It's like a little frog. And then this was another little breakfast dish that I had with like the country crock butter and toast and cottage cheese on there. And that's all the colors that I used. So it's just 2 days worth of colors, and that's just a regular sketch. So I don't view that as like a downfall to the challenge because I, you know, decided to break out my colors. Instead, how I've kind of interpreted that is that I really, really need art in my life for myself to function. And it just has really brought awareness to me how important art has become in my life. And it just really balances me out. And that's all this challenge has really, really shown me, is that it's really, really important for me to have some sort of art in my day and that I need it. It's not just like a want or a desire. I really, truly need to have that to kind of bring me to balance and to peace, to bring kind of some sort of color or some sort of drawing into my life. And I think that's awesome. I am loving that about this challenge, is that I was able to discover this. You know, I had a very high stress week, and all I had to do was sit down for 5 minutes and bring out my watercolors, and I was instantly at peace. I mean, I went from anxiety here to, I mean, just plateaued at like a normal level. And just, I felt like a million bucks. I felt like I just had the best therapy session. You know, I just felt like I had, you know, this grand, wonderful, euphoric feeling. And that is something wonderful that I can take from this challenge, to know, you know what, you really need this in your life. It's not just, you know, something that you're forcing. It's something that comes naturally to you and makes you feel great. So that is really what I take from that. I don't take it as a con at all. I just take it that I just need it. And if I get to that point again, you know, for the weeks to come in July, I'm just gonna do it. I'm not gonna, you know, prevent myself from doing that, where I'm gonna have, you know, eye twitching, or, you know, where I'm angry or feeling upset. I'm just going to do it. I'm just going to take them out and do it. For the rest of the Hobonichi, I started on July 1st, and I am doing like the typical Hobonichi drawings. So just daily sketchings I'm doing. And a lot of you have asked, because I have the faux Hobonichi, what I plan on doing once I go back to it in August. And I think what I'll do is I'll just take pictures of these, and then I'm going to glue them into my faux Hobonichi, because I don't want the month of July to be not have anything, and I don't know if I really want to resketch everything, so I might just take pictures and put them in once the month is over for July, and just so that the pages are full. And you know, keeping track of weather again at the top here, the moon phases are already in the Hobonichi, so I don't have to worry about that. And then I had a picture of my sister and my brother-in-law. They're doing their rehearsal dinner together, and it was really a great night. It was really fun. On the 4th of July, I took my daughter, and my husband and I, we took my daughter to, they have like this festival with like hot air balloons and all this stuff. So she had just a blast looking at all that stuff. And then on my sister's wedding day, I drew a picture of her and her husband. He's a fireman. And so they have these really cool shots of them by the fire station. Like, we went to the fire truck and they lowered the ladder and we got to sit in the basket and all that kind of stuff. So that was one of my favorite pictures. My husband actually snapped a picture of it, and so I redrew that in here. And then the next day we went to a barbecue for my sister and my sister's in-laws. We went to a barbecue there, and that's when my daughter, I'm really looking for words today. My daughter started her like tantrums. I don't know if it's because she's so tired from the wedding and she's kind of just catching up, and, you know, we're getting back into a routine of things, but she has just been a pistol, I'll tell you. And then on July the 7th, I started kind of decorating a little bit with drawing in washi tape and then drawing in squares. I've seen a few people on the Hobonichi websites mention that they decorate by drawing in like little squares, and, you know, I thought maybe I could try and draw like washi tape. Same thing with like up here. I tried drawing in like a little washi tape to make it look, you know, more fun type of a deal. And then here I just drew that I had to take out my watercolors and use them, and I was reading a book. And things like that. So that's working out really well. I thought I would be really, really limited with, you know, using the A5 for my Hobonichi compared to using the A6. But honestly, with the Sharpie fine pen, I just draw smaller and write smaller, so it's not that big of a deal. I haven't felt, you know, restricted at all. You know, if anything, it looks cuter because I'm able to like fit everything in on the pages. I, you know, don't tend to want to use too many stickers or too much washi because it would take up too much real estate. So if anything, it's just, you know, forcing me to do more drawing versus filling in with stickers and washi tape. So, you know, if you're challenged with a large space in the A5, this may be a great size for you. So far, so good. You know, I don't consider it being a breakdown that I did take out my watercolors. If anything, it's just been a realization that I really truly do need some sort of art in my life. I do also want to announce that I am in the sketchbook school. I saw people talking about that and was fascinated, and I've shared with all of you that Danny Gregory is, I just love that guy. I think he's so inspirational, and he's got a whole bunch of artists that are teaching this course online. So if it's still open, I will check and see if enrollment is still open. I know the first day started July the 4th, so we're past that date, but I will check and see if enrollment is there. It was $99, and I think it's well worth it. It's very inspirational, and I love it, and I will be doing that. So if you're in there, I'll see you in that classroom, because I know you can post and interact with each other, which is lots and lots of fun. If you guys are looking for how others are doing in the challenge, if you're taking part with us in this challenge, if you go to tagboard.com, which is awesome, I've never even heard of it until recently, but if you go to tagboard.com and put in hashtag onebookjuly 2014, you'll be able to find anything and everything that has that hashtag. So everyone's pictures and Tumblr posts and things like that, you'll be able to find all of that on there. So if you go to tagboard.com, and I'll have a link for that down below as well, and then check out my blog. I a lot of times will have closer pictures. If you guys want to see closer pictures of things, I'll have that there. And then I'm also working on getting a P.O. box in case you guys want to send me letters and things like that. I've had a few of you reach out and wanted to do that, so I'm going to work on getting a P.O. box so that, like, if you guys want to do snail mail or anything like that together, let me know down in the comments if that's something you'd be interested in. And I think the first week went really, really well. I will keep you guys up to date. Every Wednesday I'll have a video up for you guys to let you know how it's going, and hopefully the month is calmer. There aren't as many parties and things that are going on, so, you know, I maybe won't have as many breakdown moments, and we'll see how it goes. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys again soon. Bye bye.